me what happened in this moment in Odessa, because according to some sources, you have explosion and the Russian army, they are trying to, I don't know, to enter in the city. What happens in reality?
Let's say that it was the attempt of the shelling early in the morning. That's for sure, because I woke up from the sounds, but I woke up from the sounds not of explosion, but of the opposite, like, you know, the sound when the missile is starting. So probably it being the anti-missile systems that been working, at least the sound being closer to these. As for now, in the downtown, everything is calm. There is definitely not the open assault from here. None of this information confirmed. It doesn't mean that it is not planned and that it would not happen in the few hours, but at least right now, this data is not confirmed. My sister is living near the seaport. So we just talked 2 minutes ago, and she said that in the port it looks at least as calm from the top, because you know you remember it is the port
okay,
is down.
You don't have in this moment military ships or something in the port, Russian military ships or something.
No, nothing like this as for now is confirmed. So that we don't have the data, and we don't hear any actions as for now in the airspace. For example, I live in the downtown, so it's like I would hear if something happening just here.
Okay, and what's the atmosphere in this moment in the city? The population, they just walk on the street, go to the jobs, or they are panicked, or I don't know, in the shelter or something.
No, people are not in the shelter because there were no sirens, and what we have as for now, the people are calling to each other, asking what is happening, and I mean, what they heard from their parts of the city. That is definitely, we are following the news. There were some problems with the mobile connection, but internet is working as for now, as you can see. So I can't say that people are panicking, but definitely on the high alert, because the president just announced the martial law and the airport is closed.
Okay, what does it mean, the martial law, for the people from your city, for example? What does it mean?
The martial law, first of all, gives the rights to the government and security services, to the armed forces. They can check any cars, they can take the cars and other transport in case of necessity. It means that they can limit. It doesn't mean that they immediately do it, but they have a right on the short notice without any special announcement or something to close entrance to the certain areas, for example, and so on and so on. So, and to spend differently financing for the armed forces. So that, let's say that for most of the people, it can be not that much visible, but that gives a serious authorities to the government and to the security, to law enforcement agencies, is better to say, police and others.
Okay, I understand. There was some population prepared for any danger of war in these days, volunteer training or something like that. Do you have some this kind of activities organized by municipality or something in Odessa?
Yeah, it's not just the municipality. On the 1st of January, we launched the Territorial Defense Forces of Ukraine. I am not, what is the difference with the classical reserve, that these people are preparing, trained and gathered only for the regional level activities. So, for example, the guy from Odessa cannot be sent to Chernihiv. He is trained, he knows who is his commander and how everything is going, but he should be only for used in Odessa region for protection of critical infrastructure, for example, or the stuff like this. So that is what we like had for the last few months. People been lining to sign such contracts, people being trained, but usually it takes at least several weeks to be fully trained and sign the contract. So a lot of people started joining only the last few days, and it will be still the question of their, I mean, like legal possibility to use them. But at the same time, a lot of people have been trying to take the first aid courses within the last few weeks. And also the volunteers and the former veterans, they've been uniting and definitely trying to follow everything what is happening. And I'm expecting that these people will come immediately to the support. In terms of the general protection, I know that our municipality been organizing different not only meetings, I mean, as the to discuss, but they've been preparing the shelters very seriously. And they've been signing, for example, contracts with the supermarkets, so to have a stock of food in case of emergency. So they've been trying to be as active as possible for the civil preparedness and resilience.
Okay. I want to ask you something for context, because we know in 2014, you know, the Odessa experienced unrest and clashes between pro-Russian nationalists and Ukrainians. How is this is the situation now between, I don't know, the pro-Russian, the Russians?
Yeah. So the question is quite a complicated. First of all, because there are some number of population who are really pro-Russian, but it is more of the pro-Soviet Russian. You know, that's not something given with the contemporary Russia, that nostalgia. Okay. And unfortunately, we have them, and we have some members of the local municipality with the contacts with the Russian Federation. Leaders of those protests in 2014, they left the city there in Crimea or in Donbas. So there is no like a real leadership among these. However, we also have quite a serious gray zone of those who are just ready to surrender, for example. I mean, on the thing that if Ukraine will be independent, they will be prohibited to speak Russian language. What is total bullshit for sure. But I mean, these myths, Russia being spreading within the social networks. When a few days ago, it was a voting for the territorial defense forces financing in the city council, we know that a certain amount of the members of the city council didn't vote for this. So you can consider these people as those who may organize any type of the pro-Russian protest in the city. However, that's also the question, you know, sometimes these people are very brave when it is just the political statements, but as soon as the real fighting is happening, they are hiding and understanding that any pro-Russian actions will be a treason now, and they are becoming like thinking twice about their actions.
Okay, I understand. And what is your expectation for the next days? What do you think will happen about the conflict? Maybe you will leave the city, or what do you think?
As for now, people are not going to leave the city. I mean, definitely somebody is panicking and maybe going to their relatives or something. That is a normal process when this is happening. But we don't see any mass evacuation or anything here, at least in Odessa region. What is the expectation? Everything would depend on the several things happening today. First of all, is definitely how successful Russian will be on the east and on the south. And as for now, we see that it's not a blitzkrieg for them, for sure. But still, a lot would depend how this assault would go. And the second, it would depend what the international community would do now and what will be happening right now from that side. How effective will it be, or just the statements of the deep concerned and how bad is Putin?
Okay, I understand. And you are now you are at home, or you are you have?
Yep. I'm at home, just in the downtown Odessa, and taking calls from your colleagues from around the globe.
Okay. Thank you very much, Anna, and I hope the things will going well, and good luck. Thank you very much.